This screencast pertains to the materials in Module 2, Lesson 20. It's based on mostly the problem set, including several word problems this time. We're going to solve this using the procedure that we have established in the previous lesson. First, we're going to estimate, then we're going to solve, and then we're going to check. So to estimate, we need to do some rounding, and we are going to round first our divisor, and 32 rounds to 30. Now we're going to look for a number that is close to 84 and is easily divisible by 3. We're going to go with 90 this time. We're going to discuss some of our pitfalls here. Okay, so let's set up our problem. 84 divided by 32. We first have to multiply. Since we got our estimate of 3, we're going to try 3. And we'll put our 3 up there, and we'll write multiply 3 times 32, and we get 96. 96 is greater than our divisor, or dividend rather, of 84. So that's too high. So we're going to have to try a different number. Now, we always have to be careful when we're rounding our dividend up. We are running an increased risk of having an estimate that's too high to work. So let's erase. And we can't erase it. So we'll cross that out. We'll put a 2. And we will now try 2 times 32. And we get 64. So we'll put 64 underneath the 84. We'll subtract and we get a 20. We always want to check to make sure that after we subtract and find our difference, that our difference is less than our divisor. Indeed it is. So, is there another group of 32 and 20? And is there anything else we have to bring down? The answer is no. So in this case, we are going to put a remainder of 20. Now I'll check the problem. To check, we're going to multiply our divisor times the quotient, then add the remainder. So our divisor is 32, our quotient is 2, we get 64. We're going to take that 64, add our remainder, we get 84. We can see that our check matches our dividend, so we're good to go. Let's go on to another. We have 68 divided by 17. Again, we're going to do some rounding. And we're going to first round our divisor, 17 to 20. And we're going to round our dividend, 68. 60 is our closest. So now we're going to set up our problem. And we're not going to use the problem that we used here to estimate. Okay, we're going to use the original problem. Some kids seem to be getting mixed up on that. So we'll put 68 under the tableau and 17. Our estimate was 3 for the quotient, so we'll try that 3. Now we'll multiply 3 times 17, and we get 51. We'll subtract, and we get 17. Whoa, what do we notice here? In this example, we were too low, because when I check my answer here, I get a 17. And that is equal to my divisor. So I need to go and do another step here. We want to go and think about 4 times 17. Now, in order to do that, I can just cross this out and make it a 4, and I can subtract another 17, and we get a 0. So our quotient is 4. Let's now check our answer. So I already have it written here, 4 times 17, correct? So 4 times 7 is 28, and 4 times 1 is 4, plus 2 is 6. And we'll see that again, our check equals our dividend. So we are correct. These were two examples in which for both we had to adjust our quotient. One we had to adjust down, and the other we had to adjust up. The lesson of this is our estimates are not always perfect, but with more experience we'll learn to estimate more strategically. Let's continue. We have a word problem here, and it's very similar to the experiences we just had. When Linda was dividing 82 by 43, Linda estimated the quotient to be 2. Examine Linda's work and explain what she needs to do next. On the right, show how you would solve the problem. Well, Linda rounded 43 to 40, and most of us would do the same, and 82 to 80, and that's a valid strategy. But when she does the actual problem, she multiplies 43 times 2 and gets 86. And as we can see, 86 is greater than 82. So what does she have to do next? Well, she has to try again. 2 was too big for the quotient. So we're going to now try something different. And what's 1 less than 2? Well, that's simply 1. So let's do our work. I have 1 in my quotient. 1 times 43 is 43. We'll subtract. That becomes a 7. 12. And we get a 9. And 7 minus 4 is 3. So the answer is 1 with a remainder of 39. Let's check just to make sure. 43 times 1 equals 43. 43 plus 39. We got a 2 there. Regroup the 1. And 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 1 is 8. And again, we have a good match between our check and our dividend. Continuing with some word problems. It says a number divided by 43 has a quotient of 3 and a remainder of 28. It's not a bad idea to just kind of set the problem up here. So we don't know what the number is. So we'll put a question mark there. We have a 43 for our divisor, and we have a quotient of 3 with a remainder of 28. Well, in some ways, we can just go back to our check here to find this out. So when we check, we'll take our divisor, multiply it by the quotient. Once we have a product, we add the remainder. So let's see what that number was. So I have 43 times 3, and I get 129. I have 129 plus 28 equals 7 in the ones place, regroup, and 2 plus 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5 in the tens place, and we have a 1 in the hundreds place. Let's just see if that works. We'll double check things here. So I have 157 divided by 43. And we know that 4 times 3 is 129. We'll subtract. And we get with 3 with a remainder of 28. So that checks out. So what is our answer? The number is 157. Write another division problem that has a quotient of 3 and a remainder of 28. Well, let's get started here. It's not as difficult as it sounds. We have a division problem. We do not know the divisor, nor do we know the dividend. But we know we have a quotient of 3 and a remainder of 28. Well, what do we know about these remainders? We know that the remainder has to be less than the divisor. So if we have a remainder of 28, we need a divisor that's greater than 28. So we'll pick a divisor that's greater than 28, and we'll pick something that's easy to work with. Let's try 30. Now we're in familiar territory. Like the previous problem, we can multiply the quotient times the divisor and add the remainder. So let's do that. 3 times 30 equals 90. And I have 90 plus 28 equals 118. So we can set up the problem as, and let's just try solving it. Okay, so there's our problem. So 30 goes into 118 3 times. We subtract, we get a 28. We have 3 with a remainder of 28. Let's finish. It says Mrs. Silverstein sold 91 cupcakes at a food fair. The cupcakes are sold in boxes of a baker's dozen, which is 13. So she's selling them in boxes of 13. It's an old expression where the baker would traditionally throw in one free item when you bought a dozen. She sells the cupcakes at $15 a box. How much did she receive? Okay, well, we know that we have 91 cupcakes. And we have to find groups of 13. So you know there's 13 in each group. But we don't know how many groups. So we can divide and we'll find out how many groups of 13 we have. So we have 91 divided by 13. Now I could round 13 to 10. And I could round to 91 to 90, and that's going to give me 9. But I can tell you right now, that's not going to work. Because I know that when I multiply 13 times 9, I'm going to get something a lot bigger than 91. So I'm going to adjust my estimate before I get started to 8 and see how that does. So I have 13 times 8, 24. Whoops, a little mistake there. We'll fix that right now. 24, regroup the 2, not the 1. And 8 times 1 is 8, plus 2 is 104. So even that estimate is too big. So let's try again. We'll try 7. And we'll do 13 times 7. And we get 21, regroup. 7 plus 2 is 91. So after a couple adjustments in our estimates, we finally get the correct answer. And 91 minus 91 is 0. So we now know that she sold 7 boxes of cupcakes. And she makes $15 a box. So to illustrate that, we know that we have 7. And they're 15 each. And what is our total? We need to find that, and that'll give us the amount of money she receives. Well, if we add 15 over 7 times, we can just multiply. Seven times 5 is 35. Regroup the 3. 7 times 1 is 7, plus 3 is 105. She received 105 dollars.